We offer viewers a free subscription to the Prayer and Worship Guide, which contains the TV Mass prayers, the scripture readings, as well as special seasonal prayers and reflections on the weekday Mass readings. For your free copy, call toll-free 1-855-855-MASS. So that's 1-855-855-6277. Or write to Heart of the Nation, P.O. Box 14428, Milwaukee, Wisconsin 53214. To order online, visit heartofthenation.org. Your privacy is important to us, and we will not share your name or contact information with any other organization. If you're watching on YouTube, be sure to subscribe to Heart of the Nation channel. Just click below. Please remember to send in your gift to help support the Heart of the Nation Sunday Mass. Thank you, and may God bless you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
Today is Corpus Christi Sunday, a.k.a. Body and Blood of Christ Sunday. Very important day for us to reflect on the mystery and wonder of the Eucharist, the sacrifice of Christ at his altar. And so, brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
We glorify.
And let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how for 40 years now the Lord your God has directed all your journeying in the desert, so as to test you by affliction and find out whether or not it was your intention to keep his commandments. He therefore let you be afflicted and hunger, and then fed you with manna, a food unknown to you and your fathers, in order to show you that not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of the Lord. Do not forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert with its seraph serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless ground, who brought forth water for you from the flinty rock, and fed you in the desert with manna, a food unknown to your fathers." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the cup of blessing that we bless, is it not a participation in the blood of Christ? The bread that we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because the loaf of bread is one. We, though many, are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the Jewish crowds, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, How can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, Amen, amen. I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you will not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Corpus Christi Sunday. Body and Blood of Christ Sunday. Number one thing to remember today, the Eucharist, you know, the body of Christ, is absolutely tied to Christ's death on the cross. Absolutely. Now, I've got one of those weird things about Jesus Christ to explain to you. It's one of those things you just need to get in your head if you're really going to understand the gospel. Jesus Christ is priest and victim. He is the Lamb of God. He is also the one who raises up the Lamb of God, who offers up the Lamb of God. That is a critical detail. He must be both. If the crucifixion was just an execution, Jesus would still be a victim, but he wouldn't be functioning as a priest. He's not offering anything up to God. He's just dying. Likewise, if the Eucharist was just an ordinary meal, Christ would still be a priest. Pretty obvious he was the prayer leader for that night, but he's not the sacrificial offering. That would have been the mere bread and wine. But instead, Christ is both priest and victim. He is the subject and the object of that sanctifying action. On the cross, Jesus offers himself. I have the power to lay down my life and the power to take it up again. In just the same way, he offers himself at the Eucharist in anticipation for his death on the cross. Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you and for many. He makes both acts sacred through himself. So for those of you watching at home today who are unable to come to Mass and actually receive the Eucharist on Body and Blood of Christ Sunday, aside from your spiritual communion, which I'm sure you're making, I ask of you a simple spiritual exercise. Sometime today, in commemoration of this tremendous day, I want you to look upon the cross and remember the tremendous sacrifice that Christ has made for us. And it's enough to just be thankful that we have such a glorious and exalted high priest and Lamb of God. He will never stop loving us. And therefore, he will never stop sanctifying us. And behold, he will raise us up on the last day. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. And brothers and sisters, as we are one body in Christ, we offer up our prayers as one united church.
For the church, that we, though many, may truly be one body as St. Paul envisioned, nourished by the body and blood of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For elected leaders, that they may hunger for a just society, and that their hunger may drive them to work for justice for the least of the women, men, and children they represent, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For an end to gun violence in our nation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who struggle in deserts of poverty, of loneliness, or of emotional emptiness, that they may find sustenance and hope, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who suffer from sickness, physically, emotionally, and spiritually, especially among our viewers and listeners, may Christ's healing bring them comfort. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have gone before us, that they may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the needs and prayers of all of our Heart of the Nation parish members, including those joining us from the states of South Carolina and Maine, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, who know that our life in this present age is subject to suffering and need, hear the desires of those who cry out to you and receive these our prayers of those who believe in you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his holy church.
Grant your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery in the offerings that we here present through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for at the Last Supper with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished Lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful by this sacred mystery, you make them holy, so that the human race, bounded by one world, may be enlightened by one faith and united by one bond of charity. And so we approach the table of this wondrous sacrament, so that bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all the hosts of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jerome our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with all the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer one another a sign of that peace, especially to those viewing at home. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may take delight for all eternity in that share of your divine life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Offer viewers a free subscription to the Prayer and Worship Guide, which contains the TV Mass prayers, the scripture readings, as well as special seasonal prayers and reflections on the weekday Mass readings. For your free copy, call toll-free 1-855-855-MASS. So that's 1-855-855-6277. Or write to Heart of the Nation, P.O. Box 14428, Milwaukee, Wisconsin 53214. To order online, visit heartofthenation.org. Your privacy is important to us, and we will not share your name or contact information with any other organization. If you're watching on YouTube, be sure to subscribe to Heart of the Nation channel. Just click below. Please remember to send in your gift to help support the Heart of the Nation Sunday Mass. Thank you, and may God bless you.